Good morning, students. In today's class, we'll be taking up the functional group called as ketones and their IUPAC nomenclature. A ketone is written like this, where the central carbon mentioned here is a C double bond O, and on both the sides it should have R groups. The two R groups here are nothing but carbon chains or alkyl groups. R and R dash are CN H2N plus 1 alkyl chains. They may be same or may not be. If they are same, it is called as a symmetrical ketone. And if they are not, it is known as unsymmetrical ketone. Moving to the functional group, the structures of such groups, I am taking the first example here. A ketone, the simplest ketone, would have at least one carbon on both the ends. This is also a symmetrical ketone. The second example is when I am taking a ketone with one carbon on one side and two on the other. Third example is a ketone with two carbons on both the sides. There's a fourth example which I'm taking is again a ketone with five carbons in all, but the ketonic group is on the second carbon satisfying the hydrogens. You end up in these structures, all of which are ketones, because in all the structures you have a ketonic group flanked by two R groups. To identify a ketonic group, you need to check a C double bond O, and you should have both the sides carbon chains. This is a symmetrical one. What about this? One carbon this side, two on this side, unsymmetrical. What about this? Two carbons here, two carbons here. So this is also symmetrical. And about this? Three carbons here, one carbon there. Again, unsymmetrical. Moving ahead with the IUPAC nomenclature. Now, for the IUPAC nomenclature, you need to count all carbons of R, R dash, plus the C of the ketone. After doing that, you need to name it as alkene. After doing that, remove the E at the end and you need to add ONA. Hence, the name of the compound becomes alkanone. Don't forget, you need to mention of the position for the one at this point. So, your name would finally look like alkan, a number here, and then an ONE. You have to put a number here. For example, specifying this clearly, what exactly do I mean by this part of the nomenclature? Have a look at the first example. In the first example, what is the total number of carbons? 3. So the name is propane. I am removing the E and I need to add the ONE. The ketone is at what carbon? The second carbon. If I count from here, it's the second carbon. If I count from here, it's again the second carbon. So it becomes a propane 2-one. In some books, it is also written as 2-propanone, which is also correct, but the latest way of naming ketones is this. Coming to the example number 2, how many carbons do I have? 1, 2, 3 and 4. If I start numbering from here, the ketonic carbon gets the third position, while if I do it from here, it gets the second position. So, what would be the correct way of numbering it? Which I have already specified. The correct way of numbering it would be that you number it from the right. You have the first carbon, the second carbon, the third carbon and the fourth carbon. So, total carbons are 4 in this. So, the name becomes butane. Remove the E, add ONE. You need to specify the position of the ketonic group, which is the second. So you can write it as butane 2-one or 2-butanol is also acceptable. Coming to the next example, this one, how many carbons do we have? 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So the name has to be pentane. Removing the E, I need to add an ol. The ketonic group is at what position? If I number it from here, first, second, the third position. From here, first, second, the third position. So it is immaterial. Which side do you start the numbering from? The name remains the same. The answer is pentane, 3-ol, or 3-pentanol. Coming to the last example, which is this. How many carbons do we have? 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 again. So the name is pentane. I need to add an ol because of the ketonic group. I need to know the position. In this case, if I number it from the right, 1, 2, 3, 4th and then 5, I get the 4th position as for the ketone. But if I number it from the left, 1, 2. So the numbering has to be from the left, so that your ketone gets a lower number. So the value is 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Pentane, and your ketone is at what position? 2. So the name should be pentane 2-ol. With this, I end my class. How to go about ketones, what are ketones and how are they to be named, whether they are symmetrical or they are unsymmetrical, the end conclusion of today's classes, you need to name a ketone like this, where it is an alkane, remove the E, add the ol. The number is definitely to be mentioned because it is not a terminal group. It always comes in between the carbon chains. Since it is coming always in between the carbon chain, you need to mention its position. Thank you.